Hey guys and gals, no intro for this video. This is just a little experimentation I'm gonna do. I've been watching a lot of videos by the Craftsman, Steady Crafting. If you want to look him up, he's got a lot of fun videos, a lot of how-to things, and something's been kind of getting at me that I wanted to try. So I've got various little pieces here. If you've been following my channel for any period of time, you know
anything about this topic,
you may know what these are. These are the fins to my Strataforce Megazord that I've had to fix a few times. My latest attempt was plastic welding the little bits. Haven't tried yet because it's been curing for a period of time. The Strataforce is very prone to breaking. And whenever I would try to find a new one, I would find these broken. I don't have it on me. I put it away. I have more pieces somewhere there. Various fins broken. And I have a lot of transformers and a lot of power just stuff that are starting to have brittle plastic. For instance, you know, or missing pieces in general. Like my Zenith Carrier Zord, I'm missing one of the little guns that I can't really find easy on eBay. One of my new Sentai purchases, it's got a little spring system for the clips, and it's missing one of these, just for the little locking thing. I've got three, but I'm missing the fourth one, so it doesn't hold together as well as it could. And so I figured, you know, why not experiment with making some silicone molds and casting new pieces? And that's something that the Craftsman has been showing how to do for quite a while. I do have new versions of these that I managed to get. I noticed with mine, when I was getting ready to prep them, that they're not exactly straight. And I wonder if that's why they break so easily. They're kind of warped. Whereas if I get these, if you put them together, it's perfectly straight. So these will be the ones that I'll be making casts of. this is going to be my first time doing this. As my mother famously told my sister growing up, don't be like Tyler. Don't do what I do, because what I do may be wrong. So I'm going to get this all set up, all prepped. I have a hot glue gun currently heating up. This is probably the worst way to do this. I could not go out to get smaller cups, so most likely I will be wasting a fair bit of this. I'm fully prepared to, and we're going to go through this together, so expect a lot of jump cuts, because this is not going to be a typical video for me. So to start things off, I went ahead and I cut a toothpick to fit inside of there, so when I do make the molds in the cast, it's not going to goop inside and fill those in. I want these to be as hollow as possible. And I didn't want to use the pins because they do have that kind of knurled tip on it. So getting them out is going to be very, very difficult. So I cut a toothpick. I did that. Went ahead and got a solo cup and I cut it to about the right height. The best way that I can think to put these in is just to do it straight up, either like this or like that. I would love to have it somewhere flat, but I want to capture all that detail that's on both sides. And I don't know the best way to do that just yet. So while I am going to be wasting a lot just to have essentially two of those inside, it's the best thing I can think of right now. And this is a learning experience. We're going through this together. So I've got my hot glue gun. I'm going to put a little dab of glue inside. And I can't figure out the best way to do this, so I'm just gonna stick him right in there. I'm going to redo that because I didn't like how it turned out. And plus, I just had way too much glue. This is not a good glue gun. I need to get a new one, but putting a little thin bit like that, obviously going to work a whole lot better. I'm just going to put that on the other side and hope for the ding, dang, dong best. So, not perfect. It's all right. They'll hold. I wish I could try to find a way to kind of cut this off and channel it, but that's just how it's going to be. I could maybe like if I fold that in, I don't know. That's how it's going to be. And at the end, maybe I'll just cut off the excess. So my hope is that doing it like this, when I flip it over to pour in the actual solution, liquid plastic, resin, I think it's resin, that since I'll have these little fins at the top, since they're the narrow bits, it'll all flow down to the bottom. I am concerned about these little details down there and whether or not that'll actually fit. But as is, that's set. So with that done, I can now focus on these. These are the Moldstar 15 the Mold Star series, that's a 15 starter, 15 slow, which means you have like 50 minutes before it cures, and then it'll take 4 hours to fully cure. So yes, this video is going to take a while to make. You basically mix it 1A and 1B by volume. So I went ahead and I got two little cups here. This is a solo video, and I used a toothpick because I'm lazy, and I just stuck it inside, and I just went around marking where the toothpick is. So when I do fill this up, I have somewhat of a proper line. I did the same thing on that one. So never used these before. A little bit nervous. Went ahead and got some spoons because, of course, I didn't get large popsicle sticks. So it says to stir well before using.
I'm going to go ahead and get my new little guy. Ooh, about to lose the spoon. Don't lose the spoon. Hold on to the spoon.
All right, so all stirred up. May have been a bad choice of spoons. I heard a slight cracking when I was vigorously stirring this. So the thing to do now is pour it in. Now, this is the part that I'm probably the most nervous about because I know I'm going to waste some of this. I know that all of this is not needed for what I'm doing, but I am still kind of jittery. So we're just going to... Oh, you know what? You know what I didn't do? I have something to pour those two in, but I don't have anything to pour them together to mix them. About to lose my spoons. Don't lose the spoons. So I gotta get a new cup. All right, there we go. So here we go. As Mario would say. So I'm just gonna let that pour. Don't want to pour too much. Gonna let it even out. I'm definitely using too much. All right, so we'll try that out. Save as much as I can. And you can see using my little dots, it's actually level. You can't see because if I tilt it too much, it'll spill. So that one's done. Now let's do the same with you, Mr. Part B. And let it disperse a little bit. I think that's good enough. Now we gotta mix these two. We gotta stir them up really, 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 really well. And I'm gonna just get you. Let you go in. Oh no! Oh no! I'm so nervous. My anxiety is like peaking. All right, get as much as I can out of there. Because you wanna have the ratios as close as possible for the chemical reaction. So you want to get every little bit that you can. And this is definitely the wrong kind of cup because there's all kinds of little grooves and divots. But I was not going to go out and face the stores just because I needed tiny like bathroom cups. These I got off Amazon. And if I had actually been a patient person, I would have definitely... I just gone ahead and gotten the cups as well. So there's that one done. My hands are all goopy now. We're going to pour in the part B. But hey, you know what? Learning experience. Wrong kind of cup. Wrong kind of stirring utensils. My hands are all goopy. So now we just stir everything up. And I feel like we're pretty well mixed. I'm not seeing any swirls of the clear left in there. It's all just one solid color. So now we pour. And pray that it works. I am going to do it kind of slowly. I don't have any kind of vacuum chamber or pressurized anything. So there are definitely going to be bubbles in this. I just want to do it carefully. I'm seeing a bunch of bubbles going in. I just want to do this kind of carefully and hope that I actually have enough to cover these guys. And as I feared, I am just shy of having enough to cover it. So we're going to try to do this. We're going to try to eyeball it. All right, so that is done. The pieces are covered. There isn't a very, very thick layer on top of them. I'm kind of tempted to add a little more, but I'm just going to try it as is. And it's going to take about 40 minutes. Yes. If you look here, I have the 15 slow. 50 minutes of pot life. 50 minutes while it's still goopy. And then 4 hours to cure. So it's currently like... noon, 11, 1, I have no idea. So I'm going to set a timer, let this sit for 4 hours, and then we'll come back and see how it's looking. All right, so it's been about 4.5 hours, almost 5. It feels pretty solid. Look, don't judge me too heavily. This is my first time. I went ahead and stuck 2 batteries in there just to add more volume and make it rise over my 2 little bits. Next time I do this, I'll be a lot more prepared. I'll buy properly sized cups. I realize half of this is basically wasted. I fully understand that. We're just going to have to deal with it. So I started peeling away my cup. I do have slight concerns about my pieces like coming off or tearing through the silicone. All right, so that came off well. There's the glue, there's the bottom. And, oh, it feels nice and solid. So I got my X-Acto knife, so I can go ahead and just do little slices and hope it'll separate. Pull those out. And hey, I can cast batteries now, I guess. So like realistically, I'm probably gonna cut off a large chunk of just the sides. I don't know exactly where, like the fins, because they kind of jet out to the side. I don't know where they are exactly. So the best thing that I can do is just go down there. Now let's see if I cut deep enough. I also have concerns with the tops of the fins being so close to there. I'm kind of worried about it splitting. So let's see if I've cut enough out. All right, so the piece is out. One concern that I had, and that's why I added in the toothpick, which may not have been a good idea in the end, because given that there's that big gap at the bottom, the silicone went inside and kind of fused in there. So when I go and actually put in the resin, I don't know what that's going to do. So I'm a little concerned that I may have to redo this entire thing, but I mean, inside it looks good. I did have to cut out a couple of little pieces. That's probably going to come back and bite me in the end. I'm definitely probably not going to be happy with the results. But it's a learning experience. So let me cut out this other piece and we'll get it out. All right, so now that both of the fins are out, I'm pretty much convinced this is going to go absolutely horribly. It looks okay at the top, but it's once you get down to all the messy bits, that's where the problems are going to lie. So, I don't know what's going to happen, but I got that set up. I need to get some rubber bands to actually clamp that. With those being so thin, I have a lot of concerns about it actually going inside all the little nooks and crannies. I'm really, really concerned about it actually dripping through there, but it's a learning experience. Went ahead and got a whole bunch, and I realized my rubber bands are actually they're kind of old. I don't want any that have like really, really super tight fitting, because I know that can affect everything. You don't want it to be too tight and compress your molds. So I got that one up top. That one I will go down a little bit. I want it to have some tightness. I don't know if one's enough. I'll try that out and see. I feel like one's enough. Maybe I'll put a second one just to be safe. What's a good one to use? I don't want all these big guys. See what I meant? Old bands. Old rubber bands. Let's just... How about you? How about you? No, you're too big. Yeah. 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 That looks all right. Looks all right. I'm really concerned about pouring it into those little teeny tiny bits. I really, really am. But I've come this far. So, like before, I've got the smooth on. This is the white semi-rigid urethane resin. And white semi-rigid urethane resin. Limited shelf life. Use as soon as possible. Well, that's frightening. That's intimidating. I'm going to get the plate that I was using for my hot glue gun just in case I make a big old ding-dang mess. Because I know I will. And I know that you can pour... I've heard that you like pour liquid inside and then pour it into the cup to get an idea of how much you really need. Given that it's so tight in there, I don't know if that's really going to help. So I'm just gonna do what I really shouldn't. I'm going to get a spoonful of one, maybe 2 spoonfuls of each, and then stir them up and hope that's enough. Oh, I'm really nervous. One thing that gives me a little bit of confidence is that these are way more liquidy than the silicone. So maybe it'll drip through okay. So let's just go ahead and do this. Let's take you out for now. Because I know I'm going to make a mess. So let's go ahead and get... one spoonful, two, three. We're going to do four. I think I'm going to go ahead and do five because these aren't really coming out fully filled. So there's that one. All right, so that might be enough. So we're done with blue. Now we're going to do yellow. Again, super, super nervous. But these aren't coming out as much. So I'm going to add two more just to be safe. All right, so one reason I went with these, this is the Smooth-Cast 65D. The craftsman himself uses this kind because you can kind of rotate your molds. And I think it's called rotocasting, I think. Does it say on here anywhere? I don't see anything. And help to fill all the nooks and crannies. And that's definitely something that I want. So let me go ahead and stir that up. I probably have too much, and honestly, I'm okay with that. All that we can do now is pray. Let's see if it actually... Okay, I'm seeing some air bubbles popping out. I don't know if you can see that. Some is dripping on my table. This table's seen some horrible things lately. I'm gonna go ahead and give that a little to maybe help nudge it down. Seeing some air bubbles coming out, so I guess that's a good thing. I guess it's actually flowing down. So they're being like, it's such a small piece in general. I just don't know if it's gonna fill it. I'm gonna have to redo this. Use a better technique. That is no surprise at all. And so I can't tell. Like I probably put too much. I definitely have. Wow, I've got a lot still in the cup. Well, I guess that's really all that I can do for now. Just hope for the best. So that is a... Let's kind of flex it some more. You know what? Doing that, it's actually... There's a little bit of a gap forming. So tempting fate here, but let's go ahead. Ooh, it's starting to get warm already. So go ahead and put... Wow, is it already curing? Like, is it already going off? Holy moly, like, it's already thicking it up! What? I didn't think it'd go off that quickly! We're in for it now! So, all that I can do is, look at all this going to waste. Look at this. Aye. Well. I've let that sit now. Let me check my little booklet. So the 65D has a pot life of 2.5 minutes? And a cure time of 10 to 15 minutes. I thought it'd take like 6 hours. All right, well, I'll check this in 15 minutes and see how it's going. I didn't know it was that quick. I'm so intimidated right now. All right, so it's been 15 minutes. I'm incredibly nervous. We're gonna see how this looks. I definitely made a big ding-dang old mess at the top. But thankfully, that's just gonna peel right off. That's good. I already see a little pocket where it didn't fully fill the cavity. As I kind of expected. I honestly thought this would set like more transparent, but it's flat out white. And you know what? Guys! Aside from some cleaning up I gotta do, that looks fantastic. I mean, there's some weird, like, little divots. It's definitely more flexible than I would like, but honestly, that looks way better than I thought it would. I have to clean up some bits of it. I even went back and I snipped the toothpick inside of this. If I had to do a second version, I got a random cat hair inside. I mean, I have to clean up the top, That's expected. I'm going to have to, like, sand it and everything. But that looks way better than I thought. It even got the little hole that's at the top there. All right. That looks great. I'm really impressed. Let's try the other one.
This is amazing.
Yeah. It's a little messy. It doesn't have the little poker on the end. So, you know, that's going to take some doing. I mean, I could probably drill a little hole and put a little tiny peg or something inside there, but overall, for my first attempt, I am genuinely shocked at how well it looks. I did a very poor job doing this, but you can see there they are. So once I cut out that middle bit, and so, yeah, so if I do another version of this, which I really want to make a better mold, this is overkill. I mean, I'm going to have to cut off a large chunk of this. This is overkill. This is stupid. I want to keep this just as a reminder. I'm so excited right now. But you can see, if I put those side by side, this one turned out way better. It has the little peg on the ends. I got to clean up the edges. But, I may look into different types of resin because the flexibleness doesn't bother me too much. And actually, it makes me feel a little better because the gun that I'm going to do for the Zenith Carry Zord is a very rubbery plastic. And so if this has a little give, I mean, that's fine. I just got to clean up the edges. And I'm going to see if this will fit the Megazord. I have to drill out the little bits. But I'm shocked. I am disappointed that this one, the only big hiccup is that it's missing the points. And it certainly has the points, so... Wow! I genuinely expected this video to end with me just really devastated and just like, well, this is a learning experience. And even making a joke, it's like, take a shot every time I say this is a learning experience. I'll get that a little cleaned up already. Wow, we did it, guys. So yeah, I'm gonna end the video here. See, look at it's just, I don't necessarily want that. I don't, at least if I, you know, it's not something that I that should have that kind of give. I'm just gonna tear that off. I cut a little too much. Of course I did. So yeah, I'm gonna have to experiment and find the best way to do this. Ooh. But for a first casting, I'm very blown away. So that is it for this video, guys and gals. Thanks to the craftsman, Steady Crafting, for the inspiration to do this. I'm glad it turned out as well as it did. It's not perfect, but this was my first attempt. And I think for a first attempt, I'm very, very happy. I'm gonna go test fit these and see if they work. I'm gonna sand down those bits, but I'm liking this. So thanks for watching this video. If you've made it this far, I certainly appreciate it as always. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you want to see more actual toy videos, you can click any of the little buttons on the side there. If you want to subscribe to the channel, I got a little doodad up there. Be sure to hit the little bell. I do have a Patreon if you wanna pledge to it, as some fine people have already. I will see you around. Take care.